we are going to study the lesson Silk Road from your textbook Snapshot. This is a very interesting lesson and it has been written by Nick Middleton. The name of the author is Nick Middleton. He was a great author, British geographer, and chiefly known for his travelogues. Students, the lesson is titled as the Silk Road, and the first question that arises in our mind is that why the lesson is titled as the Silk Road. You can see in the picture the red lines. Basically, the Silk Road was a network of trade routes which connected the East and the West. The Silk Road derives its name from the lucrative trade in silk. That is to say, most of the trade was done through this road, through this route that connected East and the West. And now you can see that silk was just, you can say, transported from East to the West, and perhaps for this reason the lesson is titled as the Silk Road. And as for the lesson is concerned, this lesson is about the narrator's journey, narrator, that is to say Nick Middleton's journey to Mount Kailash. This lesson basically is a travelogue and it just tells us about the journey of Nick Middleton to Mount Kailash, and he just wanted to complete the Kora. Kora means Parikarma. Parikarma. And Nick Middleton gives a very realistic as well as interesting account of the beauty of nature, the hardships of the journey, and the people living there. Students, the journey of Mount Kailash in itself is very, very interesting to know. It very interesting to see, because Nick Middleton, when he just performed the journey, he gave the minute details of his journey, that what happened during that journey. First of all, let me just introduce the characters that you are going to come across during the lesson. The first character is Lamu. The author Nick Middleton had gone to Tibet to do Kora. When he went to Tibet to Kora, on the way to Mount Kailash, he had to stay at Rawu. That is the first place that you come across in this text with native people. Lamu was the girl of the family with whom he had stayed for a few days. She developed a friendship with the author, and as he was to leave Rawu, she gifted author a drokba, a long-sleeved sheepskin coat that men in Tibet usually wear. Put on. Lamu felt the author did not have enough warm clothes for the severe cold he was to face later on while completing the Kora, and perhaps for this reason, she gave a coat, sheepskin coat to him, a warmer coat to him. The next character is Saturn. The narrator Nick Middleton had hired his cab to travel up to Darchan, the second place you come across during the journey, Darchan from Rawu. When he was going from Rawu to Darchan, he hired a cab, and this cab belonged to Saturn. Saturn was an expert in driving through the rugged Tibetan terrain and high altitude and rough roads. At Darchan also, when the author fell ill, Saturn took him to Darchan Medical College. So Saturn was really helpful to the author in Tibet. And the third character is Daniel. Students, you can see that the first is the narrator himself, and the second is Lamu. That was a little girl who gave sheepskin coat to the author, and then it was Saturn, and the third one is Daniel. Daniel was the translator whom Nick Middleton had hired. He helped the narrator to communicate with the local Tibetans. He accompanied the narrator up to the town of Hor, that is to say one more place. Already you have come across two places, that is to say Darchan, and one was Rawu, and the third one is Hor. There he parted from him as he was to go to Lhasa. Fortunately, he got a ride in truck to Lhasa. And the fourth and the last one is Norbu. The author met Norbu at Darchan. He was a Tibetan who worked at Beijing at the Chinese Academy of Social Sciences. He had also come to do the Kora, that is to say Parikarma. Both of them struck friendship and decided to do the Kora together at the end of the lesson. These are basically the four characters, four main characters, that is to say Lama, and then Saturn, and then Daniel, and then Norbu, and the narrator himself, if you count him, that is to say the fifth character. These are the characters, and now you see that how the story develops. The first, that is to say leaving Rawu, the author left Rawu in the company of Daniel and Saturn. Before leaving the place, Lamu gave him a gift. She gave him a long-sleeved sheepskin coat. Already we have talked about. The next destination was Mount Kailash and set a new shortcut. He said the journey would be smooth if there was no snow. That is to say, Saturn shows a shortcut, and he was sure that it would help them in their journey if there was no snow. Then, when they were just, you can say, passing through these places, they passed by the hills. They could see their lonely Durugbas, that is to say, a tribe is there, tending their flocks. These people were tending their flocks. They were men and women, well wrapped. They would pause and stare at their car, occasionally waving as they passed. The local people, the local citizens, civilians, Durugbas, they were just basically tending their flocks, and they were, you can say, passing their lives in those hilly areas. And you can see that the narrator has given the minute observation of the people, the nature, and all such things. Then the Tibetan mastiff, you see that the mastiff, as they passed the nomad stands, there were the Tibetan mastiffs. They would explode into action as they neared the tents. They barked furiously. Tibetan mastiff basically are the dogs. They barked furiously and completely fearless. They would chase the car for some distance and would then go back. Because you can see that these dogs, Tibetan mastiff, they were very dangerous. And when they saw that the people are coming to their tents, to the tents of the nomads, they just basically started barking, and they were fearless, and they were chasing the author and his car also. And then the hardships that just are beginning now, ice blocking their way. The turns became sharper and bumpier. The sudden and unexpected fall of snow started blocking their way. Both the author and Daniel got out of the car, for certain to drive it safely, taking sharp bends. They were at 5 to 10 meters above the sea level. The icy top layer of the snow was very dangerous. The car could slip off the road. The snow continued blocking their way as they reached 5,550 meters. The atmospheric pressure became very low, and Saturn opened the lid of the petrol bank to release the evaporated fuel. The author experienced severe headache, and these are just basically are the hardship when you have been asked in the examination about the hardships, that is to say, faced by the narrator Nick Middleton during the journey. You have to write down all these things. First, it's about the Tibetan mastiff, you have to write down, and then the ice blocking their way. That Saturn just, you can say, took a shortcut, and he was sure to, you can say, reach the Mount Kailash at another time, but now you can see that it was very, very, you can say, hard to reach the Mount. Examination, you will be asked about this town, that you have to give the description of this town. Four was grim, miserable place. There was no vegetation whatsoever, just dust and rocks. There was accumulated refuse everywhere, and like the past, the place no longer appeared for you. And the author perhaps here wants to say that the place Four was known for his sanctity, for his holiness, but he was just waiting to reach this place. And he just wanted to feel this holiness, sanctity of this place, but it was not possible because now it was very grim and miserable place. There was no vegetation, and moreover, he was not feeling the kind of sanctity and the holiness that he was told. Reaching Darshan. By 10:30 p.m., they reached a guest house in Darshan, and the author had a very troubled night. His sinuses were blocked, and he was not able to get enough oxygen, and finding it difficult to sleep. Most of the night he sat up and was not able to sleep. This is also a hardship. You can see that when he reached the Darshan, the place Darshan, was very, very disturbed, and you can say was not physically fit. Or you can say even he was not taking, or you can see he was not able to take breathe. He was not able to breathe. Visiting the medical college. The next day, Saturn took him to the Darshan Medical College. The doctor told him it was just cold and the altitude giving him troubles. I gave him some medicine, and that night he was able to sleep well. After having taken medicine, he was able to sleep well. You can see that how difficult was the journey, and how Nick Middleton just, you can say, faced all such hardships. And Saturn leaving for Lhasa.
Satan left the author in darshan and went away. He did not mind if the author would die in darshan, was a good Buddhist and believed in life after death. That is a very humorous episode. You can see that when the author Nick Middleton just basically asked him that if he died there, certainly it was the answer of Satan that he was a Buddhist and he didn't mind if he died in darshan, was a good Buddhist and believed in life after death. However, he was worried it could affect his business as he may not get more tourists to be accompanied. Certainly, it would be a very bad thing for him if a tourist was left by him and if he died. It would not be a good thing for his business. And then, darshan. Like how darshan was dusty and heaps of refuse could be seen all around, there were not many shops in darshan. The town appeared to be, you can say, populated. He felt lonely as there were not any pilgrims. He was expecting so many pilgrims, but there were no pilgrims. And in the examination, he'll be asked that why he was very, you can say, disillusioned, why he was in despair when he reached darshan. He had reached there very early in the season because there were no pilgrims. There were no pilgrims. And there he met Norbu. The author wanted to reach Mount Kailash to do Kora, but he didn't want to do it alone. He wanted a company. And that's why he was looking for someone who could speak or understand English. When he was sitting in a cafe where Norbu saw him reading an English book, he came and introduced him to the author. He was a Tibetan but worked in Beijing at the Chinese Academy of Social Sciences. He too was there to do Kora, but he was not a religious person. Both of them decided to climb Mount Kailash. And here your text basically ends. And we have not been told whether Nick Middleton reached Mount Kailash or not. But the lesson ends here. You see that there are so many other things to be noticed here. The text is very interesting. I just basically explained the text, the important terms and the characters and the story and the summary. And you can have the content also in PDF format in the same portal. You can just visit the PDF. You can just have the PDF in this same portal. And thank you very much. Thank you again for listening to me, for having, you can say, with 1.5 hours. Thank you once again.